Good morning, it's the 21st of November. I'm Sharad Kutan and welcome to BFM's Morning Headlines, when we scan the newspapers for its deeper agenda. And sometimes we just make comments about it. The Star, depressing headline, My Dad, My Lover. It's not just the question of the father taking advantage of his daughter, though it was consensual. It's the fact that a venerable newspaper like this resorts to a kind of Harian Metro headline. I really don't know why this is on the front page. But if you're interested in the ongoing kerfuffle around the graffiti that was erased in Johor Bahru by the municipal council, there's a little bit there. That's a bit of redemption for the morning. We go on to My Cards. Yeah, newspapers, they love these facts, you see. So we have 565,157 My Cards reported lost or stolen. The question is, are they getting the wrong hands? And even if they did, what doesn't the technology help prevent its misuse? I'm not sure. I thought it did. But there you have it. The Malay Mail actually has a version of that story, but what they do is they crunch the numbers down for you. They turn it into a 2,000 cards lost every day. So there, if you're mathematically challenged, the Malay Mail is there to help you out. Also important is this story on Moody's. It's a rating agency, and they've changed the outlook from stable to positive in terms of the outlook for our economy and economic management. There's a very interesting paragraph though in the story in the NST, which notes that Moody's and Standard & Poor's actually control some 80% of the ratings market. Now, it is a market. I think it was a bit of a cynical entry there, but important to note that that's in fact the case. And that's repeated in our financial dailies. Both the Malaysian Reserve and Edge Financial Daily have that story. There it is. Malaysia's outlook now positive, says Moody's, and the Edge Financial Daily too. But the important paragraph is this, and it says, while the execution of the government's fiscal reform program will be politically and administratively challenging, Moody's expects it to result in narrower fiscal deficits that will stabilize Malaysia's debt dynamics. Debt dynamics, is that a euphemism? I think so. In fact, the word for today is euphemism. Now, no point reading Utusan Malaysia. Well, the headline is this: not unexpected, an attack on the federal opposition Pakatan Rakyat. What's more interesting is this side. You see, it says the Iklan kepada Akhbar Melayu terus jatuh. That means the Malay paper's share of ADEX, or advertising expenditure, has fallen. And with headlines like this, no wonder. Perhaps there are deeper reasons they're not getting into it, and neither am I. Rita Harian has this. It continues its look at the problem in the immigration departments, collusion between syndicates and officials to allow for entry into this country by illegal immigrants or undocumented workers. And here you have a very interesting picture, actually, because it's actually a kind of, these two men have been apprehended. And the word is cikup. Cikup means to be caught, I imagine. And it's kind of a still from an actual arrest. Interesting. Oh, just not to forget, the God in Hawaiian shirt. Yes, he is there, Tuhan Harun. He's been caught. And that's also on the Star's front page, Tuhan Harun held. But is he the person behind the Jaib murder, the Jabatan Agama Islam enforcement chief who was gunned down? I'm not sure, and neither are the police at this point. Harian Metro, Tuan Harun di cekup. So cekup again, but that's not the word for today. Euphemism is. Interesting stories here though. On the side, we have, here's a little girl. Now she and her mother haven't been able to get her an IC because, according to the Perak National Registration Department, she looks so different from her mother. She has different skin tone. Now, her skin tone and the difference between her skin tone and her mother's is apparently a reason to deny this 12-year-old an IC and therefore access to education. If that's not outrageous, I don't know what is. Or perhaps stories about very pretty women with a neck problem. You see, again. Okay, we end on a more depressing note. Sina Harian goes, so Harian Metro is not funny. Siapa Nabila? Remember the non-story about Villa Nabila? Well, that's the front page. And the Tuhan Harun, God in a Hawaiian shirt story. that cover both the entirety of Sina Harian's front page. Very, very depressing. But don't let that depress you. Perk up. There's much more than the print media in this country. There's the alternative media and the internet-based media, and perhaps they'll give you a clearer view of what's actually happening in this country. Thank you very much for listening to me. I'm Sharad Kutan. This has been BFM's Morning Headlines, the 21st of November, BFM 89.9.